There is suffering in the streets, in the streets. Our leaders say, let it be, let it be. We the people.
Those of us who have been in a war-torn region for the last 20 years, infrastructural developments like schools, health centers, roads have been totally destroyed as a result of this war. And if you are going to promote things like football that has been introduced by this association, we actually need to think of rebuilding even the schools, because for sure this program extends to all the schools in the district.
Has made many children to change, because in this place you have been hearing about war which has been here for many years. You find many children are not going to school, they just stay in the camps, others are just there in the streets. So before Kasifa came, these children had nothing to
do. I pray to be forgiven in all that I have been good. I pray to be encouraged. For under your guidance, O God, we are always resilient. Not so bad, just ask my heart to be.
One man like me pays the price so that thousands and thousands of kids can benefit from the little pain that I'll go through. But that's all right. That's why I do this. It gives me a lot of inspiration when I see I can do so much for so many people.
Have a food drive happening, or a mitten drive, or a coat drive, and the stuff disappears, and we never see what happens to it again. But the fact that Anthony brought those pictures, and they can say, oh, those are the microscopes that we actually donated, or oh, those are BCSS uniforms, I think it really, really has a major impact on these kids, that they're actually seeing somebody use these things that they took the time to collect.
I always get up at 6 o'clock, sweep our compound, prepare myself and walk 5 kilometres to school. We stay in our school without breakfast and lunch because it isn't given. I enjoy football. I also read storybooks. I shall continue to be happy with the link between school and yours. Thank you. Yours sincerely, Adio Jadif.